For joining us up top this Friday night, a weekend festival in Minneapolis that will give you a taste of some of the best flavors that the state has to offer. The Taste of Minnesota is back for its second year since its reboot, not only with mouth-watering food, but a great lineup of live music and swag that is so Minnesota. Gordon Severson is live downtown with a sampling of the fun. Hi, Gordon.
Hi, yeah, the first thing you're going to notice when you come downtown here is all of the fencing and barricades. The security team tells me that they have more than a mile's worth of fencing that is part of the perimeter here in downtown. The second thing you might notice is that it's a much bigger space this year. They tell me that the event is 2 times bigger than it was last year, with twice as much space to walk around and enjoy all of the food and music here in downtown.
After a successful year one at the new Taste of Minnesota,
we've doubled almost everything that we tried to do last year.
Organizers say year two will be bigger and better.
So we have twice as many food vendors, twice as many artists.
With 50 food trucks to choose from, with every style you can think of, from Mexican and Chinese to cookies and hot dogs.
Last year went extremely well. I think the only check in the con box with that was the heat. The heat was a little bit of a challenge, but people still showed up and it was packed.
With better weather and more choices for food and live music, organizers are also expecting twice as many people this year.
We hope to see 100,000 people each day.
Director of security Scott Gerlicher says they added 2 new entry points this year to get people through the security checkpoints faster. Their security team includes more than 100 private security officers and dozens of Minneapolis police.
We really had no significant incidents whatsoever related to public safety, and we want to build on that success this year.
They want to build a new summer tradition.
I think it's here to stay.
That will always be free, so every Minnesotan can join in the fun.
Just want people to be safe, be hydrated, and come down, have a good time, get your dancing shoes on. The music's going to be fantastic.
They also added 2 new green spaces so people can sit down and enjoy their food, and they added a zip line, which you can see right here. They tell me it's about 300 feet long. It'll cost you a little extra to ride on that. Also, Metro Transit is offering free rides to and from the event. If you still have questions, head to our website at care11.com. We posted a guide with everything you need to know.
All right, sounds good. Thanks, Gordon.